Today, we're going to look at four common hard engineering strategies used to protect coastlines from erosion and flooding. These man-made structures each come with their own set of advantages and disadvantages. Option 1, groynes. Groynes are wooden and concrete barriers built perpendicular to the shore. They trap sediment carried by longshore drift, widening the beach. The pros of a groyne: it provides a wider beach and reduces wave energy. It also looks good for tourism, as the wider, sandier beaches are more attractive. However, the initial cost is moderate, averaging between £10,000 to £30,000 per groyne. However, it requires regular repair. Groynes can also cause downdrift erosion. This starves beaches further along the coast from sediment, as a result, potentially increasing their erosion elsewhere. Option 2 is a seawall. Seawalls are solid concrete or stone barriers constructed at the top of the beach. Their primary function is to reflect incoming wave energy back out to the sea, protecting the land behind them from both coastal flooding and erosion. The benefits of a seawall are they're extremely effective at preventing both cliff and promenade erosion, and stopping waves from inundating low-lying areas. With regular maintenance, a well-built seawall can last for 50 years or more. However, seawalls have a high cost. Building a seawall can exceed £5,000 per meter, making it one of the most expensive coastal defences. Seawalls also have an impact on tourism, as their harsh, artificial appearance of a seawall can take away from the natural beauty of a beach and may put off some visitors. Some seawalls can cause wave reflection by bouncing wave energy back out to the sea, and seawalls can accelerate beach scouring at their base, meaning more frequent repairs could be needed. Step 3 is gabions. A gabion consists of a wire mesh cage filled with small and medium-sized rocks and stacked to form a flexible but porous barrier against the waves. The benefits of a gabion is that it is cheaper than a seawall, costing only £1,000 to £2,000 per meter. It is also eco-friendly, allowing over time for vegetation to grow through the wire mesh, helping the structure to blend with the natural landscape. And it's good at energy absorption, as the gaps between the rocks can dissipate wave energy, reducing the force that it reaches the shore. However, gabions only have a limited lifespan. Wire cages can corrode in 10 to 20 years, meaning they need to be replaced, and they are often not suitable in high energy zones, as these areas have powerful waves and gabions may not offer enough protection. Option 4 is rock armor, or sometimes known as riprap. This uses large boulders placed along the shoreline to break up and absorb wave energy. Riprap is durable, as it uses natural stone boulders that are extremely long-lasting and require very minimal maintenance once in place. They also offer effective energy dissipation, as their irregular surfaces of the boulder often disrupt and weaken wave energy before it can erode the coast. However, there are high transport costs in moving these heavy rocks by truck or by barge, often meaning that it can cost over £2,000 per meter, and sometimes it can limit beach access, as the uneven rocky surface can be difficult and potentially hazardous for beach goers to walk on. Each hard engineering strategy offers strong protection, but also involves careful trade-offs, balancing cost, maintenance, and environmental impacts. When choosing the right approach, coastal managers must weigh these factors to balance safety with community and ecological needs.